Hello, and welcome again to Secure Cloud Provider. We're going to talk a little bit today about Microsoft Purview. We've had lots of inquiries about this, particularly with regard to records management, and that is the specific component that we're going to cover the most today. But I also really want to bring out the other areas of Azure itself that integrate with Purview and some of the things that you need to watch out for and think through as you're setting that up. I like to go over some really key functionalities of Microsoft Purview and also specifically to review what sort of capabilities the various roles that are granted not just in Purview itself, but also in Microsoft Entra ID and the larger Azure ecosystem, what kind of capabilities those roles would grant. So right now we're on the Compliance Manager page, and we can come back to this later. First of all, what I would like to show you is that records management exists as one piece within Microsoft Purview, right? So to go there, we could go to the home page and just take a look at the solutions that appear here. This does not show you all of the solutions. It doesn't even show you records management here. But if you expand this to see all the solutions, you're going to see the three core solutions of audit, compliance alerts, and settings. And then below that, you'll see risk and compliance, within which you would have records management. This allows you to automate and simplify the retention schedule for regulatory, legal, and business critical records. However, there's a lot more. You can also have data governance, your data lifecycle management capability here, and there's a lot to that as well. And then you also have data security with data loss prevention and insider risk management, et cetera, which is very important. And then your knowledge center here. So this gives you a brief look at where records management sits within the Microsoft Purview service. And then Microsoft Purview in turn sits within the larger Azure ecosystem. And we'll briefly touch on that in a moment. So to start with records management, here we see the file plan, which is critical, of course, for this particular effort and project. You also have, of course, your policies, and then you have your classifiers as well, trainable classifiers, etc. And this is part of just the records management itself. However, there is a lot more to this. If you go over here to the settings here within Microsoft Purview, if you look at the settings right here, you're going to see records management down here and some of these other capabilities and functionalities here as well. And then you're going to see roles and scopes right here. Now, this is really critical. What we're looking at here, these admin roles, are actually found in Microsoft Entra ID. This is within the Azure ecosystem and it is not managed from within Purview. It's a very important piece to note. So in other words, the reason this matters for Purview and more specifically for records management is that if somebody has one of these admin roles to manage something else in Azure, it will also impact their ability to manage Purview and your records. Global administrators, for example, would have across-the-board capabilities, including within Purview, even if their intent was to manage Azure overall. So these are the Microsoft Entra ID admin roles, again, that would have a lot of capabilities here. In addition to that, we could manage role groups for performing the solution-specific tasks here in the role groups for Microsoft Purview solutions. And when we click on that, you can see that they already have a lot of built-in roles. Now, scrolling down, we can see there are quite a few of them. And of course, some of these are less permissive than others. But importantly, some of these out of the box are highly permissive. So organization management, just to click on that and take a look at that, we can see which roles pertain to this particular role group. This role group name you can see here is organization management. And then within that role group, you have all of these roles. Roles in the role group are going to be, you know, audit logs, case management, insider risk management, admin, quarantine, and records management, which of course matters for you, and role management, and a whole lot of other capabilities here. Now, if we exit out of this, we can also scroll down. And as noted previously, there are some that are less permissive here, less permissive roles. But this is a really, really important piece to understand because, again, if you grant overly permissive roles here or in Microsoft Entra ID, then those roles that perhaps are intended just for Purview would also have access to manage Exchange Online and other things, other, you know, email solutions or other solutions that perhaps you're not really intending to have access to. And the same goes for them having those roles and capabilities that could extend into your records management. So that's another piece I just really wanted to quickly point out. Beyond that, I'd like to quickly go over as well the solutions page here, where you can see that Microsoft Defender is key to the holistic Azure ecosystem security. Microsoft Defender, in fact, allows you to also integrate AWS and GCP environments if you were to choose to do that as well. But for the purposes of this particular exercise, Microsoft Defender is really good at providing a CSPM and really giving some insight into very important security and compliance considerations. And then Microsoft Entra is, of course, very important because these are often directory level or global roles where, for example, as previously mentioned, a global administrator would be able to come over here to Purview, assuming that, you know, the license, the E3 license or whatever is in place, and then would be able to use the existing capabilities from their general Microsoft Entra role to elevate their own privileges here within Microsoft Purview as well. So that's very important to understand. All right, so back to solutions again. Microsoft Defender, Microsoft Entra. We probably don't have time to go through all of these, but I would like to go over our, let's see here. Let's go to Compliance Manager and let's go to Improvement Actions here. All right, so your improvement actions, importantly, are going to be based on which regulations you opt in for. So by default, let's go to regulations really quickly. By default, you're automatically going to have the baseline in place. Actually, let me go to assessments first to show you that. Data protection baseline for Microsoft 365 is already included. It's not counted against your regulation licenses that you use. I'm allowed 25, I've used one, and that's this one right here. And this is actually in progress right now, as you can see, and this one is as well. So this assessment, NIST 853 Special Publication Revision 5, is one that I opted in for, whereas data protection baseline is one that is by default already included. So now to go to your improvement actions, what I wanted to point out here is that depending on what you've selected as the assessments that you want to perform, and they're going to be based on the regulations that we only briefly looked at, those regulations that you opt and say you want to create an assessment for would then appear within your assessments. And then based on those assessments that you've opted in for, your improvement actions are going to be provided. And here you can see the regulations. It's this improvement action is going to be based on this particular regulation. And if you scroll farther down here, you're going to see that only these two are going to appear. And that's because those are the only two assessments that I have opted in for. All right, so this was just a very brief overview. There's so much more, not only to records management, but also to Purview overall, and also to Azure overall. Let me quickly go to the Azure homepage, because I want to point out that with Global Admin activated, you could also, from outside of the Purview portal, you could create a Microsoft Purview account, right? This is a really important thing to understand as well. And it's important to understand that not only the roles, the role access and the role configurations matter, but also your networking. Because if you're going to create a Microsoft Purview account here, for example, you would have to select your resource group or whatever you want to use here. But then just to skip that and go here to show you this, you could have this misconfigured where somebody creates a Microsoft Purview account and says that they want to use a connectivity method of all networks. That means it's public. You don't want that to happen, right? And this is done within the Azure, the overall Azure portal, not within Purview itself. And yet it's allowing you to create a Microsoft Purview account. So you would instead want to opt for a private endpoint, of course, and then you would have to configure that. You would also want to have your tags and your configuration set, your logging, et cetera, all set for this as well. So this is a really important thing to understand in terms of the overall Azure ecosystem. Again, noting that Purview sits within the larger Azure ecosystem and can also be controlled via things like policy. So if you go and look at the tenant policy, actually first let me go and show you the management groups. Because inside your management groups, you're going to have your tenant, and then within that, you're going to have your management groups. Each of these are management groups within the tenant, and then within that, you're also going to have your subscriptions here, right? That is where you could apply your overall policy at any one of these levels. So now to go to policy, I will show you that you could potentially set up, you can create a definition, and you can create an initiative definition, which means that you're going to be able to use more than just one policy. And we're going to say that we want this to be applied not at SSO external, which is just a subscription level, but rather we're going to put it at the tenant root group. So let's select that. And now this initiative, which is going to encompass multiple policies, and I'm just going to skip the name and all that and go straight to policy so that I can show you this. Here's where you could add your policy definitions, right? So here you can filter on particular names that you want to add, right? Azure Purview accounts should use private link. You could enforce this here in policy. It's really important to have these holistic controls in place at the overall tenant level. And then you can also enable your logging, and you can determine whether you want to have, let's expand this a little bit more. You can determine whether you want the logging to go to storage or event hubs or to log analytics. You would do one of these three, not all of them. But again, you do want to have logging enabled, and you do want to have private link used as well, and you want to enforce that across your tenant level. So I just wanted to briefly go over where records management sits, which is inside of Microsoft Purview, and then in turn, what controls you want to have, not just for Microsoft Purview, but also the holistic Azure ecosystem as a whole to ensure that you have the needed controls for a fully secured environment.